Hi, this is John here with another tip and trick. And we wanna just focus on, these are our STAC clip, single T adapter clip. And these are really meant for staggered grid patterns in seismic D, E, and F to address single T connections and to meet code. But there's also a lot of applications where you can use this clip. So what we're simulating here is a very common condition in high-rise buildings where you're creating an air slot, a continuous air slot. So this would be the molding at the windows. And then this is a 2.5-inch air slot for your diffuser boot. So we typically tie in a 1-inch main, 7300 main. We have a 9/16 grid, and rarely will these be full tiles. So again, this STAC clip, see right here, we need to tie this in. I'm going to put the clip technically upside down with this going down, and that raises this up a little bit. So here, putting in this in, goes all the way in and stays out of the way of the boots. So it's under the bulb, and you can screw, or this one, I'm gonna show a pop rivet. So here you've noticed I've screwed one, and if you put this clip in where this rides on the face of the main runner, like this, it keeps the hole up higher, so less interference with ceiling tile, but you still will have some interference. So you could do pop rivet or screws. Just be mindful when you're putting the tile in that that screw is there. And if this air slot's going around the perimeter of the building, you will have directions where you'll be attaching mains versus tees. And same concept, works just the same. Pop rivet screw. So here, you know, if you have a tegular ceiling coming in, it's very common that that air slot needs to be a 1-inch main for the diffuser boot to sit on. So you can elevate your grid by 1/4 inch, and then you don't have to scribe in at the perimeter. A lot cleaner detail. On a previous tip and trick, you know, we focused on, you know, cutting this and bending the grid up to elevate, and here I'll quickly show you how you do that. Okay. So cutting these, I always cut kind of upside down to my dry line. Same concept. Then I use this to bend, and I'll make sure that I got it nice and square. Bend it down. Instead of cutting it off here, it's just 2 extra steps. And then you're eyeballing 1/4 inch. And there's your